Hello students, welcome back to your science class. So student, in the previous class, in this chapter, that is Human Eye and the Colorful World, we were talking about the atmospheric refraction as well as we were discussing about that how the prism used to show the angle of incidence, angle of refraction, how we are able to find the angle of deviation. As well as the emergent. So we have understood what is the emergent ray, what is the incident ray in case of a prism, refracted ray, and how we are able to find the angle of deviation, students. Okay, angle of deviation means the means at how much angle, at which angle the ray which was coming and falls on the surface of the prism shows the deviation. Okay. Atmospheric refraction, we have seen that generally we know that the refraction is what, when the ray of a light moves from one medium to the other medium, it used to show the bending, that is called as a refraction. The bending can be towards the normal or away from the normal. So refraction occurred there. Now, if we're talking about our atmosphere, there also the refraction process occur, and that we call as a atmospheric refraction. In case of atmospheric refraction, students, we have understood that why the stars twinkle, why the planets do not twinkle, and why we used to see the apparent position of the star higher than that of the actual position. Okay, so basically if we talk about this case, so here this process occurs, twinkling of the stars or the position of the star because of the atmospheric refraction. Continuously atmospheric refraction will cause the twinkling of the stars. Then we have also understood that why there is a delay in the sunset. It means even after sunset, after 2 minutes of the sunset, we used to see the sun above the horizon, and also why we are able to see the sunrise 2 minutes before of that of the actual sunrise. So we have understood that when sun is near the horizon, then the ray of a light coming on the earth atmosphere, it undergoes the atmospheric refraction. And then when we an observer who is near the horizon, if it is looking at the sky, it seems that the light is actually coming straight, and thus the sun, it appears above the horizon. Similar thing happened even after the sunset, that it seems that sun is what, it is above the horizon. So this is what, student, this is some of the examples of the atmospheric refraction. Let us move on and try to understand the other one. So we have understood the scattering of a light. What is the scattering of a light? When a beam of a light falls on a surface, it gets scattered into all its color. That is called as the dispersion of the light. Scattering is the similar thing that when a beam of a light falls on surface or a solution, it's scattered. Okay, and the scattering occur because of the size of the particles. The particles which is present in the solution, that will help in the scattering, like we have understood in case of a colloidal solution. In case of a colloidal solution, if we pass the beam of a light on the solution, the particles, the colloidal particles, it will scattered, it will reflect all the light which is passing through it, and ultimately this will make the path visible, and this whole thing is, we called it as a Tyndall effect. Now here few things we have to understand, student. First of all, why the scattering occur? So scattering occur because of the particles present in the solution or present anywhere. The colloidal particles present anywhere is responsible for the scattering of the light. It will scatter the light, making the path visible. Now here, when we were talking about the dispersion of the light, there also we have understood that the light gets scattered. So basically, the scattering of the light leads to the color, means which out of the seven, which color will be scattered by the particular particles. So it depends upon the size of the particles. Like if a blue if a size of the particle is really very small, so it will scatter the smallest wavelength of the light, and that is the blue one. Okay, although violet is also there, but yes, blue. So blue will be scattered by the smallest particle of the colloidal if the sunlight or if the ray of a light falls on it. Then if its size of the particle is bigger, then it will going to scatter the red light. Okay, and the red light is having the longest wavelength, it is having the highest wavelength, that's why it will get scattered by the larger size particles. And if the size of the particle is big enough, then it will going to scatter the light into white color only. Okay, so we can say here that the scattering of the light, it used to impart color basically depend upon the size of the particle. So we can write it down. The color impart by the colloidal particle depends on the size of scattered particles. So the color which is imparted by the colloidal particle, it depends upon the size of the scattered particle. If the size is what? It is larger. If the size of the particle is smaller, then the colloidal particles impart blue color. If the size of the particle is large, then then the color imparted by the particles will be red. Okay, so if the size of the particles are smaller, then it will going to impart the color that is blue, and if it is larger, so it will going to impart the color that will be red color. Okay, that is the longest wavelength. Now there are some applications also. Let us try to understand how is it so. So the first one is that why a clear sky appears blue. Okay, or why we can say the color of the sky or color of a clear sky is blue. So why the color of the clear sky is color of the clear sky is blue. So basically what happened, if we talk about the color of the sky, so before we go and try to understand this concept, students, one thing we must remember that the intensity of a scattering of a light, it is inversely proportional to fourth power of the wavelength. It means if the wavelength is the smaller, then the intensity of a scattering of the light will be what? Much more. It will be higher. So they are inversely proportional to each other. So intensity of a scattering light is inversely proportional to the fourth power of its wavelength. Okay, now we have understood that if more will be the wavelength, less will be the intensity of a scattering of light, or if less will be the wavelength, more scattering of the light will take place. Now see here, in case of the color of the sky, basically we know that the intensity of a scattering of light is inversely proportional to wavelength. So shorter will be the wavelength, longer will be the, or more will be the scattering akar. So basically if we look at the video, we will find that the violet color is what? It is having the smallest wavelength, right? While the its intensity of a scattering light, that will be much higher. So then the color of the sky must be blue, must be violet, not blue. But why it appears blue? It is because our eyes are really very sensitive towards the blue color as compared to that of the violet color. That's why the sky color appears blue. So the first thing that we must write here, that is, since the wavelength of the blue color is smaller, so its intensity for scattering of light So its intensity for scattering of light is high. Okay, so its intensity for scattering of the light will be higher. So our eyes are very sensitive towards blue color than the violet color. So sky appears blue rather than white. Okay. So the first thing, that is, the wavelength of the blue color is the smaller, so it do not smaller than that of the red color. So obviously, so the intensity for the scattering, so it will show more scattering of a light as compared to the red color. But question again here, that why not violet? So because our eyes are very sensitive towards the blue color, so that's why the color of the sky is blue. Now you know that the scattering of the particle is occurring by the overall thing that we have understood by this, that is, because of the particles present in the atmosphere, which is responsible for the scattering of the light, is responsible for giving color and imparting color also, right? Now if what will happen if there will be no particles are present, if no colloidal particles will be present, so no scattering of a light take place, then what will be the color at that time? So the color will be black. How? So we can take an example of a space. In case of a space, it is a vacuum. It means in space, the color is of the sky is what? Black in color. And the reason is, since it is a vacuum, there is no particles present in it, and ultimately there will be no such a scattering of a light will take place, and thus it does not impart any color, and the color of the sky will be black in color. So we can say that in space, color of the sky is, in space, color of the sky is black. Since no particles are present, so no scattering of light will take place. So the color of the sky is what? Black. And the reason is, since no colloidal particles are present in. So this is how the color of the sky it appears. It is what? Blue in color. Now, why the color of the sky it becomes red during sunset or during sunrise? Or we can say, why the color of the sun it during sunset or during sunrise it is red in color? So, color of sun at sunrise and sunset. The color of sun at sunrise and sunset. So, basically, what happened here? Actually, what happened here, students? See, if this is what? This is the earth. So, this will be what, students? This is the atmosphere of that of the earth. And this will be the horizon. So, suppose the earth, the sun is what? It is near to that of the horizon. Okay. So, when it is near to that of the horizon, observer is what? It is here. Here is the observer. So when it is near to the horizon, then what happened? The light rays have to travel, the sunlight which is given by the sun, the light has to travel a longer distance to reach to the observer, which is here. This is what? This is the place of the observer. Okay, observer is at the horizon. So it has to travel a longer distance for the to get scattered, or longer distance to reach to the observer. So basically what happened here, till that all the light get scattered, you know, that the violet color, blue color, or the other except that of the red color, it shows the scattering much more than that of the red, because red is what? It is having the longest wavelength, so scattering will be less as compared to the other one, which shows the more scattering. So the light ray till it reaches to the observer, till that all the light ray will get scattered away. Okay, so every ray, all the rays get scattered, only the red light will be there, which shows the less scattering. And it is because of that, when the sunrise or the sunset occur, where the sun is what? Present near that of the horizon, at that time it appears red in color. So all the different colors, it get scattered away. Okay, so we can say here that light from the sun near the horizon horizon passes through a thick layer passes through a thick layer of air and larger distance in the earth atmosphere larger distance in the earth's atmosphere before it reaches to the earth. Till that what happened? All the color get scattered except the red color, thus during sunrise or sunset, sun appears red in color. Okay, so when it is near to the horizon, at that time sun appears red in color, and it is because all the color get scattered away due to traveling as it travels a larger distance. There is another question sometimes ask a student, that why in afternoon sun appears white in color. Okay, the sunlight which is coming, it is white in color, although during sunset or sunrise it appears red in color. So I hope you have understood that why during sunrise or during sunset it appears red in color, the surrounding of the sun appears red in color. So it is because of that. Now let us try to understand that what happened when the sun is overhead or sun at afternoon. So at afternoon, you know that sun is what? It is overhead or close to the observer. Now sun is not near the horizon, but it is what? Observer is still there, students. So this is our atmosphere, here is the observer. So right now the sun is what? It is just above or forehead to that of the observer. So sun nearly overhead. Now this time what happened, sunlight have to travel less distance. Okay, so light from sun overhead would travel relatively shorter distance and thus appears white. And what is the reason behind it? That here only that of the blue color, because it has to travel a lesser distance, so such a scattering. So little of the scattering can occur. So we can say when sun is nearly overhead, little of violet and blue color scattered. So very less scattering can occur, because this time it is what? It is very close to the observer, and ultimately scattering does not take place properly. But when it is near the horizon, it appears red in color, since all the colors which is present in it get scattered away except that of the red color. So it is because of this, students, that sun, it appears red during the sunset and sunrise, and it appears white when it is nearly overhead or during afternoon.